Praise the Lord. I am so excited again to share with you day three of our devotional 2.4 in your books if you've been following along. We have been talking about Noah, and Noah lived righteously in an unrighteous world. Because of this, he found the favor of God. He followed God's instructions that God gave him, and he built the ark, and he entered into it, and he was saved. Because Noah followed the instructions of God, his life was spared. We live in a world that is marred by sin, and though our hearts are vexed by the wickedness around us, we do not have to live without hope. I know that God is never going to destroy the earth with water again, but God still hates sin. The Bible tells us that Romans 3:23 says, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." We're a part of a world that has been affected by sin and by unrighteousness, and we need an escape just like Noah did. We need to have an escape. And just as God provided a plan for Noah and his family to escape, God has also made a plan for us. And just as Noah left the ark and entered into a new world, the new birth allows us to enter into a new life in Christ Jesus. We must be born again. It may not make sense to us to be born again, but when we consider how strange it was for Noah to build an ark in the middle of a desert because it was going to rain, this is strange, but Noah followed the exact guidelines that had been given to him by God. And because he followed God's plan, his family and he were spared. But he had to follow the plan exactly. He could not decide, oh, I don't like this, or maybe I should add some windows over here, or maybe I need another door, or maybe this, or maybe that, or maybe is this just too big? I'm going to cut it short on both ends because it's just too inconvenient to make this ark this big. No, Noah had to follow exactly what God said. And we are too needing an escape, and God has given us an exact plan as well. We need to make sure that we follow the plan that God has given us in his word. In John 3:3-5, Jesus answered and said unto him, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus saith unto him, How can a man be born again when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God." God has a plan. We must be born again of water and of spirit. We cannot say, "God, you are too demanding. God, I don't like that. God, I want to change it. It doesn't fit today's culture. It doesn't fit my lifestyle. It doesn't fit. It just doesn't seem right." No, we have to follow the plan that Jesus gave. We must be born again of water and of spirit. In Acts 2:38, Peter stood up on the day of Pentecost and responded when the men and women of that day said, "What must we do to be saved?" He said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost." It was as if Peter was standing there under the power of the Holy Ghost, telling the people, "This is exactly the way you need to build the ark that is going to save your soul. You need to build it so big. You need to repent. We need to find a place of repentance. We need to be baptized in the name of Jesus, and we need to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Acts 4 and 12 tells us again, neither is there salvation in any other name other than the name of Jesus. There is no other name whereby we must be saved. This is the plan, and I need to follow the plan. What would we have thought of Noah if he had decided he just didn't want to do it that way? But so many times we see people that read the word and say, no, I don't like this. I don't, it's too hard. No, this is the plan of God, and we must follow it. It is a privilege to be baptized in the name of Jesus and to have our sins washed white as snow and to experience the love, the joy, the peace, and the hope that we feel when we are filled with God's Spirit. If you have not made that choice yet, if you have not decided to obey the Word of God as it is written, can I encourage you today? It is the best thing that you can do. And if you have already been baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost, we need to rejoice and thank God and continue to pursue His favor and blessings upon our life. It is a privilege that we get to partake in the promise that God gave of having our sins washed away and being filled with His Spirit and beginning a new life with new hope in our life. God bless you today.